Now we are going to talk about metal and timber walls. Insulated and bonded metal panels are used primarily to clad industrial-type buildings. They may have facings of anodized aluminum or steel with porcelain, vinyl, acrylic or enamel finishes. In this type of walls, heat transfer, condensation and expansion should be carefully considered. Bonded metal panels may have honeycomb or urethane cores. Insulated metal panels have inner and outer sheet metal facings and sandwiching a layer of thermal insulation. In order to produce a timber wall, a properly arranged frame studs can be covered with natural or engineered timber panels and, if needed, with proper insulating products. Also, a timber frame can be filled with stone, brick, etc. Horizontal joints of engineered panels, which must be protected by flashing or other means, are very noticeable. These horizontal lines should therefore be coordinated with other exterior wall elements such as windows and door openings. Here we can have engineered timber panels directly nailed or screwed over a wooden stud. And for the connection or joints of two different type of timber panels, there can be some solutions. First of all, we can have a shiplap joint, and we can have a channel here, or we can cover the this joint with a batten. For protecting from the water, we can have this type of solution in the section. Horizontal board siding are fastened through the wall sheeting and into the wall studs with hot dipped galvanized aluminum or stainless steel nails. Nailing is done to allow the individual boards to expand and contract freely with changes in moisture content. This is the wrong nailing. We shouldn't nail one piece in two different places, but we can nail just one piece in one place and just use the other piece to fasten the down part. And if there is a water problem, we can solve this detail like this one. Vertical board siding can be laid in various patterns. Matched boards that interlap or interlock can have flush V-groove or beaded joints. Square edge boards can be used with other boards or battens to protect their vertical joints and form board and board or board and batten patterns. We can fill the void of a wooden stud and beam void with different types of stones or bricks.